Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. Today I have a note sent in by Bob, and Bob comes up with a better trick for one of my favorite tricks. This talks about how to find the last day of a month. And typically, I do this by using the date function. It wants a year, a month, and a day. All right, well, you know, to figure out the last day of the month, hard to do. 30 days, 31 days. In February, is it 28 or is it a leap year with 29? So, my standard trick for this is to use the year of the date and then 1 plus the month of the date. So, what I'm trying to do here is if we're in February, I jump ahead to the first of the next month. So, I don't bother trying to figure out how many days this month has. I just go to the first of the next month, which gives me March 1st, and then I subtract 1 from that, and we get back to February 29th. You know, it's one of those geeky solutions that's been floating around forever. Well, Bob said, hey, you know, this date function is so robust, it can understand what you mean if you ask for the zeroth day. If I ask for the zeroth day of next month, it automatically gives me the last day of this month. Extremely cool. Now, in the old Excel, of course, if you had the analysis toolpak turned on, or in the new Excel, you have the ability to use the EOMONTH equal EOMONTH from this date, and how many months out? No months out, just zero, and that'll give you the right answer in the wrong format. So we format cells, choose a date. So if you use EOMONTH, you don't have to worry about this. But if you've been using this trick of finding the first of the next month and subtracting one from it, Bob's trick of just asking for the zeroth day of the next month works great. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.